Thanks for joining us on YouTube here. This is Mike Hydeck for NBC Connecticut's Face the Facts. We're talking about the SNAP program, food stamps here in Connecticut. Could be a big change coming soon if the Secretary of Agriculture gets his way. He wants to close what he calls loopholes. That means about 11,000 households here in Connecticut could end up going without benefits to help them put food on the table. Joining me now is Robin Lamont Sparks. She's the executive director of End Hunger Connecticut. Thanks for joining us. So Sonny Perdue calls this a loophole. That would change the food table for a lot of people here in Connecticut. What are your thoughts on it?
You know, I think it's really going to make it very difficult. It's affecting our working families the most.
Yep.
Working families, seniors, and those with disabilities are going to be the people who are most hurt, but especially working families, the ones that are between 130 and 185% of federal poverty level. They have jobs,
right.
And this is really helping them and their families right now.
So right now, the larger number of the poverty level for a family of four and still getting food stamps is 131% of the poverty level. Here in Connecticut, we have much higher rents. We have much higher housing costs, so we have 185% of the poverty level are allowed to get food stamps. The federal government wants to close that gap. That's what we're talking about here. So what's the likelihood of this happening? You said this has been talked about before.
Right. This has actually been proposed in Congress twice in the last couple of years and voted down both times. Mm-hmm. And it's been bipartisanly voted down. There's 41 states take advantage of this broad-based categorical eligibility. So it's not like just a few states are taking advantage of this. It's really helping a lot of families because people recognize that the federal poverty level really doesn't recognize what it costs to live anymore.
So contention of the federal government is that there are people abusing the system. Maybe people are getting services that shouldn't be getting services. Have you heard that? You're where the rubber meets the road. You help these people fill out their paperwork and get services. Have you seen fraud?
We have not really seen fraud. I think, you know, there's always going to be that, how do we get people upset? Let's make the one-time thing that's happened and blow that up and put that out on the internet. But we haven't seen that. We've seen many more families where this is really helping them make ends meet. They're not having to choose between, am I going to eat dinner today or am I going to pay electricity? Or which one of my children eats today? We're getting rid of that. That's what we want to see end.
Now, it's clear the federal government wants to try to shrink this gap between those two numbers. Connecticut lawmakers say they're already on board. They say, we're going to fight this. This is cruel. We want to keep food on the table. How do you feel about the likelihood of this getting through Congress?
You know, I think there's going to be a lot of people upset about it. Yeah. The fact that both red states and blue states are using this, you know, like West Virginia has a 200% and no asset test.
Mm-hmm.
That's, and same with North Carolina. That's far more than even what we have, and their states are using that and still have needs. So I think you're going to see a lot of people opposed to this.
Also, one of the things that your organization does, they have a summer meals program. You're helping kids who wouldn't normally get food during the summer get food. Tell us about that.
Well, it's actually a program run by the USDA and administered through the State Department of Education.
So that's a federal program.
It is a federal program that school districts are actually, many of the school districts or towns are using. And what we're doing is really getting the word out so that people understand, like, this is available. Any child can go under the age of 18, no identification needed. They get a healthy meal. Sometimes it's hot, sometimes it's cold, but they get a chance to go sit down and eat. And that is something that we know is important in terms of their learning, keeping their development going, and we really want to see more kids taking advantage of it.
Thanks so much for joining us, Robin Lamont Sparks. Did I get it right?
Yes.
Executive Director of End Hunger Connecticut. Thanks for joining us on YouTube. We got a whole bunch of links. If you'd like to learn more about this topic and others, just click some of the other ones along the side. I'm Mike Hydeck. We'll see you next time.
This is Face the Facts with NBC Connecticut.